Good evening, and welcome to the Hopkins 5th grade concert. I would like to take a moment to thank the Hopkinton Music Association for the raffles that they're selling out in the lobby. I would like to take a moment and thank Mr. Ritz up in the crow's nest filming today's performance. The biggest thing that I do want to say before we get the show started tonight is that we could not do these programs without your support. The parent support in this town is absolutely amazing. Look at how many children are performing this evening in front of you. It's absolutely, you know, amazing. From my first year here where I had like 35 kids in the combined 5th and 6th grade band. And the town was just tiny and starting to grow. And now you look at this and, you know, we have 200 students performing for you tonight. So please enjoy this performance and thank you very much for your continued support of the Hopkinton Music Program. Next, we will start with the chorus this evening.
My name is Jessica Barkin, and I have the pleasure of working with all of your kids as the chorus director this year. They have been so much fun to work with, and we had a lot of fun, I think, they would agree with me, this spring with a couple of our selections. So I know the kids are really excited to perform for you tonight, so I'm going to hand it over to Mary Kate.
Welcome to the 5th grade talent show. Welcome to the 5th grade spring concert. We are so excited to perform for you tonight. Our first song, Summer Double Dreamin', shows your excitement for summer vacation. We have worked hard to memorize all the words and add some hand motion.
Thank you.
We have learned about dynamics or musical volume levels, balancing and blending our voices, and how to sing with energy behind our sound. This song makes me happy since I do believe in music.
Thank you.
fifth grade orchestra under the direction of Mrs. Pat Diamond.
The Hopkins Orchestra members and I would like to thank our parents, guardians, administrators, and staff members for your help and support this year. We would also like to thank Ms. Kate Plum for her help during orchestra rehearsals, and Mr. Ed Flaherty for setting up the piano and cello chairs every Wednesday. We thank Mr. Hay and Mrs. O'Toole for helping us tune our instruments this evening, and Mrs. O'Toole even magically produced two cellos when they ended up broken. I'm sorry. It is said that every time a teacher speaks, their goal should be to impart knowledge. To impart knowledge, I shall discuss our second piece. It is titled A Classical Medley. First, you will hear a piece by Leopold Mozart. He was Mozart's father. Then you will hear a piece by Ludwig von Beethoven. One day, we will play a symphony with four movements. Not today, but this medley is practice for the day we play a symphony. The second piece will directly follow the first piece without a break in between. Please hold your applause between movements, just like we do between movements of the symphony. Tonight, I don't want to list our progress points like I usually do. I would rather just dazzle you with our beautiful sound. Enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. That was a very long walk. So, I'm way over here. So, hi, I'm Caitlin McDonald. I am the director of the fifth grade band. Right up here we have some students approaching. This is our small ensemble right now. So for each concert, the students have asked us if they could do something a little more challenging. We had a lot of interest in doing this extra work, believe it or not. They came to extra rehearsals, they did extra practice, and they came early for the concert tonight. And we actually have a number of students who volunteered to do this, and we ended up picking names out of a hat. There are so many people that wanted to do it. So they're going to perform a little song for us. And I also wanted to recognize some students. We had a voluntary program called the Band Karate Program. And this was an opportunity for students to progress through a karate belt system. And like I said, it was voluntary. All the students make great progress on their instruments, whether they participate in this or not. But I do want to recognize the students that were involved in this. The way it works is they can come and they play for me and their peers individually. They receive feedback, they make improvement, and then if we see the improvement, then they get their belt. So, I'll take you through here. All the students in the band who got a white belt, please stand up. Good job. All right. Now stay standing if you got a yellow belt or above. Stay standing if you got a yellow belt or above. And stay standing if you got an orange belt or above. And a green belt or above. A bronze belt, and finally a black belt or above. Thanks. All right, so then we'll set the mic back here. Okay.
Hopkins. And while they get set up for their last song, I just want to thank all of you as parents and family members and brothers and sisters who have survived a year of fifth grade music. It's always a journey from the beginning of the year, and I know when they first pick up those instruments, they're so excited in the fall, and it takes a lot of dedication, whether they're in the chorus, for the orchestra, or the band. The rest of our school day, students, you know, learn math every single day. They work on reading every single day. Music is one of those things that we get general music, and you get an instrumental lesson. And those lessons are only once a week, and then the band gets together. And as you can see from the size, it's the number of students that most teachers would quake at. That's quite a large group, and then we give them instruments on top of that. So, to all of the music teachers here tonight, you do a tremendous job. We don't give you enough time or enough credit for what you do. To take students who have never picked up instruments or never played in an ensemble to get up here to take risks, you do a tremendous job, students, and we're really proud of you, and we're very proud of your teachers for all your work this year. Thank you.